Our passage today comes from Daniel chapter 12 and verse 3. The Bible says, "Those who are wise shall shine like the brightness of the firmament, and those who turn many to righteousness like the stars forever and ever." The Bible approaches the subject of you in two different ways. First of all, it shows you how you can be saved by the gift of Jesus Christ at the cross of Calvary. But secondly, it shows you what role God expects you to play in the salvation of other people. One of the amazing things about God's plan to save sinful human beings is that He not only saves you, He makes you a part of the whole process by allowing you to participate in the salvation of other people. The truth is, you really can't separate these two ideas. In the Bible, your salvation is closely linked to the idea of playing a decisive role in the salvation of other people. Take a look at Psalm 51, for example. Almost in the same breath, David asks God to forgive him and then pledges that he will play a part in sharing God's love with other people. Here it is, beginning in verse 12. He says, "Restore to me the joy of your salvation and uphold me with your generous spirit. Then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall be converted to you." You find the same thing in the writings of Paul. In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, he tells us that when we accept Christ, we become a new creature. Now that's talking about your salvation. But notice the very next thing he says in verse 18. "Now all things are of God, who has reconciled us to Himself through Jesus Christ, and has given us the ministry of reconciliation." Did you catch it? Doing your part in bringing the good news of salvation to other people is a natural part of being saved yourself. God not only saved you, He gave you the ministry of reconciliation. A couple of verses later, Paul says, we're actually ambassadors for Christ. And that brings me back to our passage for today, found in Daniel chapter 12 and verse 3. If you really consider what this verse is saying, it's a little mind-blowing. Not only does God give us the gift of salvation, and not only does He ask us, in spite of all of our shortcomings, to be His ambassadors to a lost world, He actually rewards us for it. Now think about that for a moment. You didn't deserve salvation in the first place. And if we're really honest about ourselves, we'll have to admit we're not exactly the best choice for ambassadors of heaven. And then God rewards you, even though He does the whole thing. Now, what does that say about the generosity of God? Just imagine, you get to serve as heaven's ambassador, and God's going to let you draw a paycheck for that. You get to shine like the stars forever in God's kingdom. And on top of that, living life to save other people is just a better way to live.